us.
Goes like this, takes a turn and comes back.
Similarly here, it takes a turn and comes back. These are called oceanic gyres. Similarly, in the Pacific Ocean it is there. Other oceans it is present. Oceanic gyres. Now, at certain point, you know, if you see this part, you understand, if you see this part, the wind here, like this one. If you see this part and this part. The wind is, the wind direction is nearly right angle to the current. So this wind will be flowing in one direction, but current will be flowing in the other direction. 90 degree. See, wind is blowing like this. Suppose you have a seat here, you know. Suppose you have a seat here. How this will be going? The wind is trying to float it in this manner. But current is taking in this manner, you know. So these are the areas where maximum difficulty, you know, in floating of the ships takes place. So this right angle relationship between the wind and the current, this was observed by Ekman. That is why it is called Ekman transport. Understood, na? See, wind is blowing towards northeast, but the current is going towards southeast. Current is going like this. This is called Ekman transport. So these are North Atlantic gyres and South Atlantic gyres. You can see here. So one of such gyres, or part of such gyre, you know, is called Gulf Stream. Gulf Stream. So this is Labrador Coast. Labrador Coast of North America. Where this gyre is known as, or western current is known as Gulf Stream. So due to this gyre, the hot water in the equator regions, you know, is taken towards pole. The hot water, alright now, I want to understand now. The hot water is transported towards pole, is transported pole water. Understood, na? Making the subtropics plus pole warmer. The same thing also happens in case of southern gyres. But northern gyres are more stronger. Because of more number of continents in the northern hemisphere, northern gyres are more stronger. See? Right? As there are more continents in the northern hemisphere, the northern gyres are more stronger. Why? The continents put a block, na? See, the wind is flowing like, suppose, like this. The continent is blocking. That is why this sea current or ocean current is taking a turn like this. Suppose here, the wind is blowing this way, suppose. Wind is blowing like this. So water is being driven like this. But this is putting an obstacle. So more number of continents makes the gyres more stronger. That is why northern hemisphere gyres are more stronger. Then what he says, you know, you can come to Pacific. Pacific, you see, these are the gyres, you know, coming like this, taking a turn, coming like this. Similarly, go to southern hemisphere, it goes like this. You see, because of these gyres, you know, like this. You are understanding, This is the western boundary. Western boundary, this is the eastern boundary. Eastern boundary. So from here, the warm water is going like this, becoming cold, cold water is coming in the eastern margin, and again through the equator it is going this side. That is how the circulation is happening. Now, can you tell me, if this type of water transport takes place, the sea surface, you know, this sea surface is not a planar surface. It does not remain as a plane. So if sea bulging takes place, the surface becomes bulged up. So can you tell me which side will be bulged up? So sea surface, sea topography is not a flat one. It is not flat. So out of these two pores, which is bulged up? So here water will be accumulated. Here, it is something like this. If you take a section this way, like this. This is the western margin. This is the eastern margin. Eastern margin. Understood this part from the table? So here, the height will be more. Not much, you know. You can say maximum 1 meter. That is the sea topography. If that is the case, here the thermocline, you know, the thermocline will be deeper than here. Here thermocline will be nearer. It will come back, come to the surface. Here thermocline will be shallower. So cold water will be touching the surface. The cold water upwelling takes place on the eastern coast of the sea, or eastern margin you say, coast is not the right word. Eastern margin, the upwelling takes place, upwelling cold water is coming down. But in this case, the sea level is higher, that means downwelling, that cold water becomes deeper. Upwelling, downwelling means that. Cold water, whether at the surface or at the deeper level. Here cold water is at the surface. So that means upwelling. Cold water has come to the surface. Upwelling, downwelling difference is this. With respect to the cold water. Not with respect to the sea topography. Sea topography is higher. So thermocline is below, much below. So if you compare these two pores, where the nutrients will be more,
Eastern
side, na? Eastern side nutrients. So if nutrient is more amount of feces will be available in the east side, eastern margin. So follow this one, na? So out of these two, which side is much richer, you know? So for a sea culture, the fish culture is concerned, this coast. This side is warmer, you know. So cool water is much below. Here cool water is at the surface. Followed, na? Now if you just compare Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea, which coast is richer? Arabian Sea is richer, you know. See? This circle you see? From western margin it comes. Here, from the western margin it goes like this. These two circles you see, I'll draw it, yeah? You understood this part, huh? What is the western margin current? This is the western margin current. This is the western margin current. So here is hot, here is cold, here is hot, here is cold. That is the thing. So India, western coast, much richer in fish than the eastern coast, this margin. maybe you may have to go here, you know, much deep to get the fish. To get the fish. But here along the coast, you will get the fish. You understand this point? You see these currents. These are called western currents, western margin currents, western boundary currents. So all the oceans are having this type of currents. These are major gyres. These are major gyres. You know. Apart from these, there are sub gyres. Sub gyres. Those things we will not discuss. Only major gyres you remember. Okay.
Yeah.
Then the temperature variation. Temperature variation. Just like wind, how wind was flowing towards north, because of here wind was getting heated up near the equator. So it was rising. So when it was rising, it has to go towards the pole, toward the cold region. So when it was moving toward the cold region, Coriolis force was drifting them towards northeast, in the southern hemisphere towards northeast, southeast. That is the effect of Coriolis force. So first is temperature. Second one is the Coriolis force. So in this case, wind is one. Coriolis force also attracts in the same way. Temperature variation, this seawater and this seawater, there is temperature variation. Here it is hotter, here it is colder. So from hot region, water tries to move towards north. So when it is moving towards north, Coriolis force is taking you to that way. So when it is being taken this way, the western margins are playing a role. Right.
Sir, in polar region, the Coriolis force will be negligible because the distance matters.
Movement is very low.
Yes.
But still then there will be something. Huh? So near the pole, you see, submantic polar currents are there. Very negligible. Very low. Very low. But this is mostly seen, you know, between the equator and the subtropic. The Gaia these areas. These areas. But Alaska current, this side, the Norwegian currents, they are existing. They are existing. As long as you have a liquid medium here, you know, and you are rotating it. See, it has to flow. And there is a temperature variation. So water has to flow. So this current, you know, goes up to say 1000 meters. From surface to 1000 meters, the current flows. At a speed, suppose 40 kilometers to 120 kilometers, you know, per day. This is the speed of the current. So naturally, when this is flowing like this, so the sea margin or the coastal margin of the land, you know, obstructs, na? The thick water is flowing, you know. Suppose the continental margin becomes very shallow. It will not go far. Suppose where the Mediterranean Ocean. Mediterranean Ocean is very shallow. It cannot go inside. It will take a very the Mediterranean Ocean. Suppose here. It cannot go inside, you know. Because it is 1000 meter thick. Water is flowing. Suppose your ocean is very shallow here. So it cannot go inside. It will take a turn here and come back. It cannot go inside. So here the Caspian Sea or these seas, you know, they do not have current. They are very shallow, you know. They do not have current. But these oceans, you know, they have current. Because you have 10 kilometer thick water pipe, you know. Understood, na? These are called gyres, ocean gyres. So many people say that ship drowned. What are the reason? Titanic ship got drowned in somewhere. Where it was drowned? Atlantic. Where is that place? Bermuda Triangle. That is called very popular. Very famous. Somewhere here. Some people say it is the plate tectonic origin. Some tectonic force dragged it behind. Some people say this may be the part of the air, you know. Where is Bermuda? Bermuda is somewhere here, no? There is thing.
That
was not there. Where Bermuda Triangle?
Bermuda Triangle is there, but that ship didn't travel there.
That ship didn't go there?
No.
Where it was?
So it was close to the northern part of Atlantic, where it was very cold waters.
Ice water.
Near Greenland.
Some people said it because of the Gulf Stream. It was dragged into the sea. But it was not an iceberg. Iceberg?
Yes.
Yes. So these guys are very strong. It can take all the ships inside, you know. Just like a deal it is making. Anyway, you must be knowing better than those Titanic stories. Okay. So we'll go to a different. Anything else? want to ask? So now, let's close it, yeah? Climate change scenario.
छिड़के करना पड़ेगा रिमोट नहीं है पता नहीं मिल नहीं रहा
climate change in a scientific manner. Suppose somebody asks you, what do you mean by climate change? You say global warming. Global warming is a part of climate change.
Sea level change.
Global warming. Sea level change.
Monsoon.
Sea level change. And what else? Monsoon variation.
Monsoon variation.
Like this?
Drought.
So these are part of climate change. But what he says, all these phenomena is the result. Result of one process in which you do not generally speak. See, you say global warming. It is the product of that process, you know. What is the process?
Rising temperature.
It is the sea level change. Sea level change is the result you see. But what happened? Why this sea level has changed?
Temperature.
That is not global warming.
Population.
CO2. CO2 is a. CO2 is a. You say it is within you. It is a cause. See, the climate change, you know, is the energy balance. Meaning of this, the energy balance between what comes from the sun, that is the incoming energy, and how much is coming to the earth, and what is going out of the earth? Outgoing. Outgoing. So how much energy, or the radiations, you know, is coming from sun, solar energy, how much entering into earth, and how much earth is giving back. So that balance, you know, that balance is called climate change. Because the sun hits the earth surface, sun hits the atmosphere, sun hits the ocean. So in the night time, the heat energy of the earth goes back, leaving something behind that balance. So the balance, you know, is disturbed. The balance is disturbed. You say it is a climate change. Why? Because this balance, you know, how much is left within the earth creates your weather, creates your season, creates rainfall, all these things. See, if the balance is lost, so all these things are disturbed. You say sea level is rising. Because the balance is disturbed. You say the global warming is taking place. Because the balance is disturbed. How much was coming and how much was going back, giving back you. Suppose more energy is being trapped. Suppose X was coming from top, you know. And you are leaving Y into the. So X minus Y, you know, is the balance. This should be solved. That earth surface temperature remains 15 degrees centigrade. This is the story for last so many million of years. 15 degrees centigrade should be there. Sun se kitna energy aaya, and how much energy lost. Balance should be such that, you know, the earth surface temperature should become 15 degrees centigrade. If Y is more, it becomes less.